Now let us represent few rational numbers on the number line. See the first question, to represent 3 by 5 on the number line. So on the number line, now 3 by 5 is a positive rational number. So first I am taking 0 on the number line. Then as 3 by 5 is a positive rational number, so I am taking different numbers right of 0 on the number line. So I am making some equal divisions, equal parts. Now the first part is represented by 1 by 5. Now the second part is represented by 2 by 5. Now you can take third part, 3 by 5, and then 4 by 5, 5 by 5, which is equals to 1. Now the next part is 6 by 5, 7 by 5, 8 by 5, 9 by 5, and 10 by 5, which is equals to 2. Now here, 0 to 1, so this is 1 unit. In this 1 unit, how many equal parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 equal parts in 1 unit. So here 1 unit has been divided into 5 equal parts. The third part, 3 by 5. So this is represented by 3 by 5. The third part is 3 by 5. This is our required rational number on the number line. Again, from 1 to 2, this is second unit. This unit has also been divided into 5 equal parts. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here if you want to represent 7 by 5 on the number line, so this is 7 by 5. Now let us see the next question. Represent minus 5 by 6 on the number line. So the given rational number is a negative rational number. So I am taking 0 on the right side. Now I am taking all the rational numbers left to the 0. So I am making all equal parts. Now the first part to the left to 0, so that is minus 1 by 6. So this is minus 1 by 6, and the next part is minus 2 by 6, minus 3 by 6, minus 4 by 6, minus 5 by 6, minus 6 by 6, which is equals to minus 1. And the next part is minus 7 by 6, minus 8 by 6, minus 9 by 6, minus 10 by 6, minus 11 by 6, minus 12 by 6. So this is nothing but minus 2. Next, minus 13 by 6, minus 14 by 6, minus 15 by 6, minus 16 by 6, minus 17 by 6, minus 18 by 6. This is equals to minus 3. So here also the left of 0, there are 3 units. The first one is 0 to minus 1. This is first unit. Now this unit has been divided into 6 equal parts. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. So there are 6 equal parts. Out of 6 equal parts, you are considering 5th part. So this is called minus 5 by 6. The minus 5 by 6 can be represented here on the number line. So this is minus 5 by 6. If you want to represent minus 13 by 6 on the number line, so where is minus 13 by 6? So here minus 13 by 6 on the number line. And minus 1 to minus 2, this unit is also divided into 6 equal parts. So this is second unit. This second unit also divided into 6 equal parts. Out of 6 equal parts, whatever you want, you can represent on the number line. And here, minus 2 to minus 3, this also divided into 6 equal parts. So to represent any rational number on the number line, so first you have to observe the denominator. So what does the denominator tell us? The denominator tells us that the unit is divided into how many equal parts. If the denominator is 5, so every unit is divided into 5 equal parts. And the numerator 3 tells us that in that how many equal parts you are considering. So that represents 3. So here first, second, third. Out of 5 equal parts, we are considering third part. So this ratio number is represented by 3 by 5. In this second question, what is the denominator here? 6. So each unit is divided into 6 equal parts. So that is called denominator. And what about the numerator? Out of 6 equal parts, which part we are considering? Minus 5 means 5th part left to 0. So what is the 5th part left to 0? That is minus 5 by 6. So this is the required rational number on the number line. Now let us solve the next question. Write the rational number for each point labeled with a letter. Here two number lines are given, and it is given very clearly that each unit is divided into how many equal parts. See here, as you observe, the denominator is 5. So each unit has been divided into 5 equal parts. Now see the first part, 0 by 5. The second part is 1 by 5. So obviously we know that the third part is 2 by 5. So here 2 by 5 represented by A. And next one is 3 by 5. The next part is 4 by 5. And next part 5 by 5. So this is equals to 1. So here 0 to 0 by 5 is nothing but 0. So here 0 to 1. So this unit has been divided into 5 equal parts. So here 2 by 5 represents A and 3 by 5 represents B. Next, C represents here 5 by 5, that is nothing but 1. Next, 6 by 5, 7 by 5. So the next part is 8 by 5. 8 by 5 is represented by D. Next part, 9 by 5, 10 by 5 is nothing but 2. Again from 1 to 2. So this unit has been divided into 5 equal parts. And next part is 11 by 5. This is represented by E. Now let us see the next question. In the second number line, so all the denominators are equal to 6. Means in this number line, each unit has been divided into 6 equal parts. Now the first part is minus 12 by 6. So immediately after this part is minus 11 by 6. So that is represented by F. Next, minus 10 by 6, minus 9 by 6. And next part is minus 8 by 6. That is represented by G. Now minus 7 by 6, minus 6 by 6. So this is equals to minus 1. And 6 ones are 6, 2s are 12. So this is equals to minus 2. Here minus 1 to minus 2, or minus 2 to minus 1. So this is 1 unit. It has been divided into 6 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 parts. So whereas in this first number line, 5 equal parts. Now here minus 5 by 6, minus 4 by 6. The next rational number is minus 3 by 6. That is represented by H. Now minus 2 by 6, minus 1 by 6. The next one is 0 by 6. So that is nothing but 0. That is represented by I. The next one is 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6. And the next one is 6 by 6. So this is equals to 1. So you have 0 to 1 and minus 1 to 0. So this each unit is divided into 6 equal parts. Here also 6 parts. So in this way, any rational number can be represented by any number on the number line. So you can easily find so any missing rational number on the number line. Now the next topic is rational numbers between two rational numbers. So let us find first how many natural numbers are there between 3 and 10. Natural numbers between 3 and 10 are 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the natural numbers between 3 and 10. There are finite natural numbers or infinite natural numbers. Obviously, we know that there are finite natural numbers between 2 natural numbers 3 and 10. So this is finite. Now, we will find the whole numbers. Between 0 and 6. So how many whole numbers are there between 0 and 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 whole numbers between 0 and 6. So these are also finite whole numbers. Now let us find integers between two integers. Integers between minus 3 and 2. So what are the integers between minus 3 and 2? Let us see. Minus 2, minus 1, 0 and 1. So how many integers are there between two integers minus 3 and 2? Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 integers between the two integers minus 3 and 2. So here also finite integers are there. Now let us see how many rational numbers are there between two given rational numbers. Rational numbers between two rational numbers 3 by 10 and 7 by 10. Here the denominators are equal. Now if you compare the numerators, both the numerators are 3 and 7. So between these two, how many rational numbers can you find? Obviously we know that 4 by 10, 5 by 10 and 6 by 10. So we can find 3 rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. But is it correct? Only these 3 rational numbers are there? The number of rational numbers between two rational numbers is, whether it is finite or infinite. Let us see how more any rational numbers are there between these two or not. Now let us find the rational numbers between two given rational numbers 3 by 10 and 7 by 10. So in the first case, when the rational numbers are in the form 3 by 10 and 7 by 10, so we can find finite rational numbers between these two. So those are 4 by 10, 5 by 10 and 6 by 10. So these are the 3 rational numbers between 3 by 10 and 7 by 10. So as we know that the numerator and denominator of a rational numbers are multiplied by the same number, the rational number does not change. So you can multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. Then what will you get? Now 3 2s are 6 by 10 2s are 20. Here also 7 2s are 14 by 10 2s are 20. So here also denominators are equal. Now here how many rational numbers are there between these two? 6 by 20 and 14 by 20. So here 3 by 10 is same as 6 by 20. Means 3 by 10, 6 by 10 both are equal. Here also 7 by 10 and 14 by 20, these both are equal. Now here between these two rational numbers 6 by 20 and 14 by 20, how many rational numbers are there? Now we can find 7 by 20, 8 by 20, 9 by 20, 10 by 20, 11 by 20, 12 by 20, 13 by 20. So there are more few rational numbers between 6 by 20 and 14 by 20. If the numerator and denominator of 3 by 10 are multiplied by 10. Now let us find how many rational numbers are there between these two. Now here 10 3s are 30 by 10 10s are 100. Means 3 by 10 became now 30 by 100. Here also both numerator and denominator are multiplied by 10. Now 10 7s are 70 by 10 tens are 100. Now here 7 by 10 became 70 by 100. Again these two are equal. Here also 3 by 10 is same as 3 by 100. 30 by 100. Now how many rational numbers are there between 30 by 100 and 70 by 100? Here we can find 31 by 100, 32 by 100, 33 by 100 and so on up to here 69 by 100. So here also we can represent more rational numbers on between these two given rational numbers. So like this we can represent unlimited number of rational numbers between any two rational numbers. As we multiply both numerator and denominator of the given rational numbers by the same number. So there are infinite number of rational numbers between any two rational numbers. For example, if two rational numbers are given 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So what are the rational numbers between these two? Here the denominators are not equal. So first you have to make the denominators equal. Then we should insert a few rational numbers between these two rational numbers. And if you multiply both numerator and denominator of these two rational numbers by the same number, then you can insert more and more rational numbers. So in this way, we can insert infinite number of rational numbers between any two rational numbers. Now let us take another example to find the rational numbers between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Here both the denominators are not equal. So first you have to make the denominators equal. Now what is the LCM of the denominators 3 and 4? Obviously it is 12. Now 2 by 3 can be represented as, if both numerator and denominator multiply by 4, then you will get 2 4s are 8 by 3 4s are 12. And the second rational number 3 by 4, if both numerator and denominator are multiplied by 3 by 3, then 3 3s are 9 by 4 3s are 12. Now here the first rational number is 8 by 12 and the second rational number is 9 by 12. But there is no rational number between these two, 8 by 12 and 9 by 12. Now both numerator and denominator are multiplied by 2. So here 8 by 12 into 2 by 2, this equals to 8 2s are 16 by 12 2s are 24. So here also both numerator and denominator are multiplied by 2, then 9 by 12 into 2 by 2, this equals to 9 2s are 18 by 12 2s are 24. So here what are the rational numbers between these two? There is only one rational number between 16 by 24 and 18 by 24, that is 17 by 24. So there is only one rational number between 16 by 24 and 18 by 24, that is 17 by 24. If you want to find more rational numbers between these two, then you should multiply by the higher number. Then multiply 8 by 12 by 5. So both numerator and denominator are multiplied by 5. Then 8 5s are 40 divided by 12 5s are 60. So here also take 9 by 12 and multiply both numerator and denominator by 5. So 5 by 5, this equals to 9 5s are 45 divided by 12 5s are 60. So here what are the rational numbers between 40 by 60 and 45 by 60? Those rational numbers are 41 by 60, 42 by 60, 43 by 60 and 44 by 60. So there are 4 rational numbers between 40 by 60 and 45 by 60. Here 2 by 3 is same as 8 by 12, that is same as 40 by 60. Here also 3 by 4 is same as 9 by 12 and that is equal to 45 by 60. So here we got 4 rational numbers between these two given rational numbers. If you want to find more rational numbers, then again you should multiply by the higher value. And 8 by 12 is multiplied by 10. then this equals to 8 tens are 80 by 12 tens are 120. So here also 9 by 12 is multiplied by 10 by 10. Then 9 tens are 90 divided by 12 tens are 120. So here you can find more rational numbers between 80 by 120 and 90 by 120. Those are 81 by 120, 82 by 120, 83 by 120, 84 by 120, 85 by 120, 86 by 120, 87 by 120, 88 by 120 and 89 by 120. So here we can find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 rational numbers between 80 by 120 and 90 by 120. Means all these rational numbers lie between 80 by 120 and 90 by 120. And all these rational numbers lie between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Now there is another method to find the rational numbers between any two given rational numbers, so that is mean method. See, for example, if A and B are any two rational numbers, if A and B are any two rational numbers, then their arithmetic mean means A plus B by 2. This is the arithmetic mean of the two rational numbers A and B. The sum of two numbers is divided by the number of numbers. Means there are two rational numbers A and B. Their sum is A plus B divided by 2. So this lies between A and B. So here A less than A plus B by 2 less than B. So this arithmetic mean lies between the two rational numbers A and B. So this is mean method. If any two rational numbers A and B are there, then their arithmetic mean lies between the two rational numbers A and B. Now we will find the arithmetic mean of these two. So here 2 by 3 plus 3 by 4. This should be divided by 1 by 2. This should be divided by 2. Then first we will find the LCM of 3 and 4, that is 12. Here 3, 4 times 12, 4 2s are 8, plus 4, 3 times 12, 3 3s are 9. This is divided by 2. Here 8 plus 9 is 17 by 12. Now which is divided by 2, means into 1 by 2. So here this equals to 17 ones are 17 by 12 2s are 24. So this arithmetic mean of 2 by 3 and 3 by 4, this lies between the given rational numbers 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So here we can write 2 by 3 less than 17 by 24 less than 3 by 4. So here 2 by 3 and 3 by 4 are two rational numbers. Their arithmetic mean is 17 by 24. So this lies between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Now again we can find the arithmetic mean of these two. Means we can find one more rational number between 2 by 3 and 17 by 24. So again we can find the arithmetic mean of 17 by 24 and 3 by 4. Means we can insert more one rational number between 17 by 24 and 3 by 4. Now first we will find the arithmetic mean of 2 by 3 and 17 by 24. So this arithmetic mean is 2 by 3 plus 17 by 24 divided by 2. This equals to the LCM of 3 and 24 is 24. Here 3 8 times 24, 8 2 is 16, plus 24 1 time, 117 is 17 divided by 2. This equals to 16 plus 17 is 33 by 24 into reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2. Now this equals to 33 1 is 33 by 24 to 48. Now this 33 by 48 lies between 2 by 3 and 17 by 24. Now here we can write this lies between here. So this 33 by 48 lies between 2 by 3 and 17 by 24, means here 33 by 48. So this can be written as 2 by 3 less than 33 by 48 less than 17 by 24 less than 3 by 4. Here the given ratio numbers are 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Now here we can find more one ratio number between 17 by 24 and 3 by 4. So this arithmetic mean of these two will be here. Now you will find the arithmetic mean of 17 by 24 and 3 by 4. 17 by 24 plus 3 by 4 divided by 2. Now this equals to the LCM of 24 and 4 is 24. Here 24 one time 24, 1 17s are 17, plus 4 6 times 24, 6 3s are 18, divided by 2. This equals to 17 plus 18 is 35 by 24 into the reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2. Now this equals to 35 1 are 35 by 24 2 are 48. So this 35 by 48 lies between 17 by 24 and 3 by 4, because so this 35 by 48 is the arithmetic mean of 17 by 24 and 3 by 4. So here we can write 35 by 48. Now this can be written as first 2 by 3, the given ratio number, less than 33 by 48 less than 17 by 24 less than 35 by 48 less than 3 by 4. So here the given ratio numbers are 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So these three are the ratio numbers between the given two ratio numbers. Again we can find the arithmetic mean of these two and these two and these two. So again we can find more ratio numbers between 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So in this way, by finding the arithmetic mean of each two consecutive ratio numbers, we can insert unlimited number of ratio numbers between any two given ratio numbers. Now let us solve a question. Represent 7 by 4 and minus 5 by 6 on the number line. See the first question, 7 by 4, we have to represent this on the number line. Now it is positive ratio number or negative ratio number? So it is a positive ratio number. So I am taking all the numbers right to 0. Now, what is the denominator in the given ratio number? That is 4. Means each unit should be divided into 4 equal parts. Now I am taking 0, then first part is 1 by 4, second part 2 by 4, third part 3 by 4, next part 4 by 4, that is equals to 1. Means here 0 to 1, so this is divided into 4 equal parts. Next part 5 by 4, next 6 by 4, next 7 by 4, next 8 by 4, that is equals to 2. From here, from 1 to 2, this is divided into 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 4 parts. Next, 9 by 4, 10 by 4, 11 by 4, 12 by 4. That is equals to 3. So here also from 2 to 3, it is divided into 4 parts. So here each part is divided into 4 equal parts. Then what to be represented on the number line? That is 7 by 4. So where can we find 7 by 4 on the number line? In between 1 and 2. So this is our required ratio number, 7 by 4 on the number line. Next, Second question, minus 5 by 6. Now it is positive rational number or negative rational number? Obviously we know that it is a negative rational number. So I am taking the numbers which are left to 0, because all the negative rational numbers lie on the left side of 0. So 0 I am taking extreme right, then I am taking all negative numbers from 0 to left side. Then what is the denominator in the given rational number? 6. Then each unit should be divided into 6 equal parts. So here first I am taking minus 1 by 6, here minus 2 by 6, minus 3 by 6, minus 4 by 6, minus 5 by 6, minus 6 by 6. This equals to minus 1. So 0 to minus 1, this is divided into 6 equal parts. Next, minus 7 by 6, minus 8 by 6, minus 9 by 6, minus 10 by 6, minus 11 by 6, minus 12 by 6. This equals to minus 2. Again, from minus 1 to minus 2, divided into 6 equal parts. So here minus 13 by 6, minus 14 by 6, minus 15 by 6, and so on. Now where is minus 1 by 6 on the number line? So it is between 0 and minus 1. So here minus 5 by 6. So this is our required rational number on the number line. If we want to represent another number line on another rational number on the first number line, for example 11 by 4. So where is 11 by 4 on the number line? See here, between 2 and 3. So this is 11 by 4. And where is minus 9 by 6 on the second number line? Minus 9 by 6. So where can we find minus 9 by 6 on the number line? Between minus 1 and minus 2. So this is minus 9 by 6 on the number line. So in this way you can represent any rational number on the number line.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.